Dear learners, welcome to the course Antennas and Microwave Engineering. In this video, I am going to explain radiation pattern of isotropic radiator, directional antenna and omnidirectional antenna. In a separate video, I have explained the radiation pattern of an antenna in detail. What is radiation pattern? Radiation pattern is one of the important performance parameters of an antenna. It is used to describe the performance of an antenna. Based on the characteristics of an antenna, the radiation pattern may be isotropic radiation pattern, omnidirectional radiation pattern, and directional radiation pattern. We are going to discuss one by one. Let's start with the isotropic radiator. Isotropic radiator is a hypothetical or fictitious radiator. It is a hypothetical lossless antenna. The isotropic radiator is defined as a radiator which radiates energy in all directions uniformly. It is also called as isotropic source, as it radiates uniformly in all directions. It is also called omnidirectional radiator or unipole. Basically, isotropic radiator is a lossless ideal radiator or antenna. Generally, all practical antennas are compared with the characteristics of the isotropic radiator. Therefore, the isotropic radiator or antenna can be used as a reference antenna. Practically, all antennas exhibit directional properties, that is, directivity property. That means none of the antennas radiate energy in all directions uniformly. Hence, practically isotropic radiator cannot exist. Consider an isotropic radiator is placed at the center of sphere of radius R, as shown in figure. Then, all the power radiated by the isotropic radiator passes over the surface area of the sphere given by 4 pi r square, assuming zero absorption of the power. Then at any point on the surface, the pointing vector P vector gives the power radiated per unit area in any direction. But radiated power travels in radial direction. Thus the magnitude of the pointing vector P vector will be equal to radial component, as the components theta and phi directions are zero. That means P theta and P phi are zero. The magnitude of pointing vector is equal to PR. The total power radiated is given by P rad is equal to integration, surface integration of P vector dot ds vector. Surface integral is nothing but double integral. So double integral PR ds. The ds is the surface area of sphere. So, what is the surface area of the sphere? It is 4 pi r square. Already we discussed the component in theta in phi directions of 0. So, therefore, P rad is equal to P average 4 pi r square, where this 4 pi r square is the surface area. So, now P average is P rad by 4 pi r square watts per meter square, where P rad is the total power radiated in watts. P average is the radial component of average power density in watts per meter square, or is the radius of sphere in meters. This figure illustrates the isotropic radiation pattern. Isotropic radiation pattern is in the spherical radiation pattern. Next, we are going to talk about omnidirectional antenna. Omnidirectional antenna is described by the omnidirectional radiation pattern. It is a class of antenna which radiates equal amount of power in all directions perpendicular to an axis, with power varying with angle to the axis, that is elevation angle, declining to zero on its axis. The radiation pattern is often described by toughnut shaped. Main difference between isotropic radiator and omnidirectional antenna is, in the omnidirectional antenna, the radiation pattern is toughnut shaped. But in the case of isotropic radiator, the radiation pattern is sphere. It is a spherical radiation pattern. Omnidirectional antennas are widely used for radio broadcasting antennas and mobile devices. These figures illustrate examples for omnidirectional antenna, monopole antenna and dipole antenna, generally used for radio broadcasting and mobile devices. This illustration represents the animation of omnidirectional radiation pattern, and this figure it illustrates the radiation pattern of omnidirectional antenna. It reaches zero on the axis. It radiates electromagnetic energy in horizontal plane. Next type is directional antenna. An antenna with the property of radiating or receiving the electromagnetic waves more effectively in some directions than in other directions is called directional antenna. When antenna has maximum directivity greater than that of half-wave dipole is known as directional antenna. The pattern discussed above is directional pattern. So practically any antenna which radiates more in particular direction and less in other direction is called a directional antenna. The radiation pattern is called as directional radiation pattern. This figure illustrates the directional radiation pattern. Here the red color portion indicates the maximum radiation in a specific direction. Others are minor lobes. And this figure B illustrates the radiation pattern of planar array. It is also an example for directional antenna. Horn antenna, reflector antenna, log periodic antenna are some examples for directional antenna. I hope you would understand the concept of radiation pattern for isotropic, omnidirectional and directional antenna. Thank you.